Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, I didn't plan this, but yet another charting question. This one comes from Mike in Arizona. Mike is trying to create something called a revenue bridge chart. Now, I recognize this as something that came out of McKinsey, a fellow named Jean Zelazny there, and the McKinsey waterfall chart. Same concept here. Mike has sales from last year and this year. Last year was $10 million, this year is $12 million, and wants to show how we got from the $10 million to $12 million. So he takes each of his five divisions here and says, okay, we were at $10 million last year. Hardware is up $1.5 million, so plus $1,500,000 there. Software, though, had a really bad year. They're down $2,200. So we go from that $11,500 level down $2,200. And then service went from that level up $1,700. Training is down 900, and then finally documentation is up 1900 to end up at our 12 million. It kind of paints you a picture of how we got from last year to this year. Kind of shows the breakdown and, you know, whether people were up or down. So when I go about building this, there's actually three series in this chart. I've done the waterfall chart before. What's unusual here, though, is the negatives, having negatives. So we have the blue series, which is the positives, the red series, which is the negatives. And then we also have another series that you can't see. That's the invisible series, the white series down here. So we'll take a look at how I set up these formulas. First thing I want to do is figure out the balance. So where are we so far? You know, it's simple equal B2 there, but then taking the previous balance plus this amount. And that's kind of the height. That's where I want that column to end. Now, my actual chart is going to be over here, so I bring my labels over. Those are just simple formulas that grab the value from column A. For the first and last point, it's always just a single positive value. So that's a formula pointing back at B2 and B8. Everything in the middle, though, these are kind of tricky, and it depends on whether the number is positive or negative. So what we do is say that we're going to take the previous balance. We're going to start at the previous balance, and if this particular value is negative, then I want to lower that base. This is the color of, this is the height of the white invisible series. I want to lower that base by the negative amount. Otherwise, we want to just keep it at the previous amount. Now, if the number is positive, we bring that value over. This is tricky, though. If the value is negative, like here, I don't want to bring the value over, I want to bring the negative value over, because I need that red bar to actually be positive. And so I've lowered the base by the amount of the negative, and so here I need this to be negative. Pretty tricky. All right, now a few things. If I just created this chart, the chart labels are going to show zeros here, and that's not what I want. So I'm going to format this series. We'll do Control-1. And I'll go into custom. We're going to use our zone. So for positive numbers, I want to show plus zero. There will be no negative numbers here, so I can just leave that zone blank. And for zero numbers, I don't want to show anything. So click OK. Now over here in the negative, this is going to be really tricky. Again, Control-1 to format this. We'll go into custom. For the positive numbers, I want to show minus zero. Because remember, those positive numbers are actually negative in the original data set, so we're going to fool Excel into showing a minus zero, and then there will be no negative, and the zeros I don't want to appear. So, look at that. Isn't that tricky? It's storing a positive 2200, but it's showing a negative 2200. Now, let's create the chart. We're almost home at this point. Insert column, stacked column chart. So there we go. We have our negative, positive, and base. For the positive numbers, let's go with a nice positive color there. We'll format that under fill, go to a solid fill, and maybe green for positive. And then for our negative numbers, we'll format that fill. Let's choose a solid fill and red for the negative numbers. And then finally, for the first series, the series that's supposed to be blank, we'll choose that. Fill is going to be no fill, and then border color, no line. Click close. That's going to make everything else float. So there's all of our floaties. We can now get rid of the scale. The labels. Labels are kind of tricky here, and I really could not come up with a good solution for this. If we choose just the negative series and say add data labels, there's our data labels there. And of course, they pick up the value from the original chart. And then we'll choose this series, add data labels. So we're adding the data labels one at a time. we get our positives. Boy, I'd really like for those to appear on top of the chart, but it's just not going to happen. There was an option in 2003 to do that. They got rid of it in 2007. If I would choose those data labels and go into format, they give me an option for inside end or inside base. Inside end doesn't really get me where I want to be. So I'm going to just, unfortunately, move these manually. Once we have those labels selected, I can now select a single label and just drag it to where I want it to be. The 1500, drag it. Whoops, missed. 1500 label, drag that. 1700 label, drag that. The 1900 label, drag. The negatives, probably want to have those be at the bottom. Now, the first click selects all the labels in the series. Second click selects the one single label. Move that one down. And move this one down. The 12,000, missed that one. All right, so two clicks to select it. And just drag that up. Now, of course, the unfortunate part is if the scale changes or, you know, anything, then we're going to have to redo those. Let's get rid of the grid lines. I think they don't add a lot to this chart. Click delete. If you wanted to, you could actually draw in little drawing objects to draw, you know, from the top of this bar over to this bar to kind of show how things are going. So up 1700, down 900, up 1900 to get to our 12,000. There you have it, called a revenue bridge chart. Also similar to something called a waterfall chart. The main trick here is to get these to float is to have an invisible series with no border, no fill. Hey, thanks to Mike for sending that question in. Thanks to Jean Zelazny out at McKinsey, a great guy who has written a couple of books about the charting, not charting in Excel, just how to chart in general. Some great theory there. And thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.